Good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. In the last class, you all had learned about using the Polygon tool. And you had also made some pictures using the Polygon tool. Do all of you remember which pictures you had made? In the last class, you had used the Polygon tool to make pictures of a crown, a tree, etc. Can you all say what is a polygon tool? The polygon tool functions like the line tool, but while drawing with the line tool, you can draw any type of line anywhere. While using the polygon tool, you need to make sure that the starting point and the end point of the polygon are the same. Can you tell whether you can complete any picture drawn with the help of the polygon tool without having the starting point the same as the end point? No, that is not possible. Since while making pictures using the polygon tool, you must have the starting point the same as the end point. Now, all of you power on your computer and open the MS Paint file. In today's class, you will all practice using the polygon tool. Using the polygon tool, the pictures that we will make today will be of a butterfly, the alphabet H, and also the words computer shiksha. And later, we will also make some other pictures. Look at this picture in front of you and tell what is it called. Yes, this is a picture of a butterfly. In order to make this picture, which tool will you need to use? You will use the polygon tool to make this picture. Can you make this picture? If you face a problem in making this picture, take the help of the video. Let us now watch this video and see how we can use the polygon tool to make a picture of a butterfly. Select the polygon tool by left clicking on the polygon shape, then go to the size options and select one of the sizes here, the size which you like for your line of the butterfly. Then we have to select one of the colors. In color 1, we are selecting black. Bring your pointer to the drawing area and draw a oval shaped polygon. For this, you have to keep clicking on the mouse when you make small lines, and you can see it's a polygon with small lines, but it appears like an oval shape. So this is how you can use the polygon tool also to make oval shape drawing. Then make this line here using the polygon tool. Just double click on it to end it. Again make a line this side. These are the feelers of the butterfly. Double click and leave the line or this polygon as is. Now we have to make the main body of the butterfly. So we can use how we make regular polygons. Make the first line. Then click on the pointer here and make the second line gets dragged on its own. Similarly, drag the third line and then close this polygon by clicking on the starting point. So the starting point and the end point are the same. Now let's make the wings. Let's do them in a different color. So we have selected color 1 as yellow. Then bring it here. Start a polygon from here to make one of the wings of the butterfly. Drag a line and then click here so that the second line gets dragged automatically. Click here so that this polygon gets continued and the third line gets dragged like this. And click on the starting point to close this polygon. One more polygon we are going to make the complete wing of the butterfly. So we drag this line here, then keep a pointer here. The second line gets dragged on its own. Click here, third line. Click here for the fourth line. Like this, just a little below. And then you can click on the starting point to close the polygon. So this way, one side of the wing has been made. Similarly, on the other side, we have to make the wings by drawing polygons. So we take our pointer here, drag a line like this. Then click at this point so that the second line gets dragged automatically. Click here for the third line. And then we can close this polygon by clicking on the starting point. For the lower part of the wing, we make another polygon by dragging the first line here. Then clicking down here. Below, second line gets dragged automatically, then we click here, a little below here, third line, the fourth line, and then we can close the polygon by clicking on the starting point. So this way you can make this nice picture of a butterfly using the polygon tool itself. Now, go ahead and show how you will make this picture on your own. If you have a problem in making this picture, then you can make it with the help of the video. Let us watch this video and see how the polygon tool is used to make this picture of the alphabet H. First, select the polygon tool by left clicking on it. And then make sure that you have the appropriate thickness of the line and the color that you want. And then bring your pointer to the drawing sheet and drag a line as is being shown using the polygon tool downwards. Then take the pointer towards the right side, click on that, so that the second line is automatically dragged. Then go upwards, bring the pointer here, click here, and the third line gets dragged. Go to the right now, click here again, and as is being shown in the video, next we go downwards to make the other side of the letter H. Go right side, keep clicking, and the lines keep getting dragged automatically. Now we have to go up here like this, click here so that the other side of the letter H gets dragged automatically. Now take it to the left side, click, go towards the middle of the letter H, click here. Then go again towards the left side now, click here, go upwards, and once this line is made, all you have to do is close the polygon by clicking on the starting point. So this way, your letter H is ready. Now we need to color inside, so select the fill with color tool and select a color of your choice as color 1. So we are selecting brown here, dark brown, and then bring the pointer inside the letter H and click so that the color gets filled inside the alphabet or the polygon edge. This is how you can use the polygon tool to make this picture. Look at this picture in front of you, which is of the words computer shiksha. Can you tell how you will make this picture? As you know, to make this picture, you will use the polygon tool, and then to fill colors inside this picture, you will use the fill with color tool. Can you make this picture? If you are having any difficulty, then watch the video and learn how to make it. Let us now watch this video and learn how to use the polygon tool to make this colorful picture of computer shiksha, the words computer shiksha. For this, you need to first select the polygon tool by clicking on the polygon in the shapes. Bring your pointer to the drawing sheet and then slowly by dragging, make the first line, second line. And since there is a curve, make small dots so that the second line, the third line keeps automatically being dragged by the polygon tool. In the end, as is being shown in the video, remember to click on the starting point because the starting point and the end point needs to be the same. So we've made C, the letter C, in double line. Similarly, we are making this O. We first drag the first line and then small lines to make and complete the polygon by clicking on the start point so that the start point and the end point are the same. Now within the O, let's make a smaller O using the polygon tool so that the colors can be nicely filled inside the O and all the letters like this. Now we are making the M. Since there are straight lines, this is going to be slightly easier. So just drag the first line and then click with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad where you want the second line to be dragged, then the third line. And in the end, remember to join the starting point and make it also the end point. Both the starting point and the end point should be the same. Otherwise, the polygon will remain open and when you fill colors, the color will be filled in the whole sheet. Similarly, we are now seeing in the video, the letter P is being drawn or made with the help of the polygon tool. Once you have made the outline, make a small polygon here also, so that again, while filling colors, it's easy and it appears nice. Next is the letter U. Again, click here and then keep clicking small lines which get dragged automatically. Make the curve for the U. Bring it to the top and then bring towards the left side. Keep going. Remember to make small lines so that the curve is better. Like this. Then bring it to the top and then join the starting point to the end point. So C-O-M-P-U is ready. Next we are making the letter T. Again, T is made of straight lines, so it is easier. As is being shown in the video, we first drag the first line, then just click with the pointer and the other lines keep getting dragged automatically. So we made T. Next is E. Again, it should be easy for you to make this because these are straight lines. So first drag this line here to make the side of the E. Then click here on the right side and continue by clicking and dragging the other lines automatically to make the letter E in double line. Like this. then take it to the right again, slightly up here, small line, and then join the starting point so that the starting point and the end point are the same. Next is letter R. Again, click here and then drag a line first downwards. Then you can make a small line here, go upwards. Remember to make the slanting line of R like this. Again, go up. Click here so that the line gets dragged, and then just like you made in the letter P, drag small polygons or small lines to make the curve part of the letter R. In the end, join the starting point and the end point. Make a small polygon inside also so that when we color, it is easy and it looks nice. So the first letter computer is written and is ready. Now let's write the word Shiksha. Again, we will make letters in double line so that we can fill colors inside them. So again, since S is made of a curve, remember to draw small lines which are being dragged automatically. First make the outline, then make sure that you make a double line for the letter S. We are dragging, and the lines, we keep moving our pointer and clicking with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad, and the lines keep getting dragged on their own. Or you can say the polygon keeps getting dragged on its own. In the end, just join the starting point to the end point. Next is letter H. You already have made the letter H, so you know how to make that. Just drag a line. Take the pointer towards the right side, take it up, then make the middle of the letter H, bring it down towards the right side, then again you can make it right up till the top here. Now since if you make a mistake, like we made a mistake in the video, we can just do undo, or we can select that, the last polygon that we made, and use the delete button on the keyboard. So once again, we are drawing the letter H using the polygon tool. First line we drag, the other lines we just keep the pointer and click, and the lines keep getting dragged automatically. Like this. Remember not to make the same mistake again. So make the middle of the letter H, bring it up here, and then just join the starting point to the end point so that the complete polygon is a closed polygon and the colors do not spill outside. Next is the letter I. Will be relatively easy because it's made with straight lines. So we can just drag the first line and then keep on clicking with the mouse or the touchpad with the left button, and the lines get automatically dragged. So again, if you don't like it, you can just undo or select the whole polygon that you have made and use the delete button on your keyboard and make this polygon again. As is being shown in the video, just remember to make it nicely so that the letters look nice, and also when we fill colors, the colors get filled in nicely. Bring it to the top here, then on the left side, and now join the starting point and the end point. K is the next letter. Again, one straight line dragged, and the other lines, just by clicking on the mouse or the touchpad left button, we make the other lines. K, bring it up here, bring it down to make the slanting part of K, then on the side, bring it up again to the middle, and then after this line, we have to draw a line slanting upwards towards the right. You know the shapes of the letters. So remember those shapes and try to make them as nicely as possible. Bring it here in the middle. Again, it does not look nice, so we can just undo, use undo to erase this. Make it again nicely. You don't have to work very fast. You should work so that the letters look nice and are in proper proportion. So you know how the K looks. We are making the K in double letter, in double line, so that the colors can be nicely filled in. Bring it up here to the right. Then small line here. Then go back towards the middle. Then bring the line to the top by clicking at the top. After the slanting line has been drawn here. And then join the end point to the starting point so that the polygon is complete. Shiksha. One more S has to be made. Remember, you can use the copy paste option also here because already an S is made earlier. So you can use the copy paste to copy it again here or make a new polygon as is being shown in the video by dragging the other lines. The first line, small line, and remember when we are doing any curved polygon, make small, small line segments, small, small polygons or lines, and in the end, join the starting point to the end point. Shiksha. So H and A is remaining. Let's make those also. H you have already drawn, so it's easy. Let's draw it one more time using the polygon tool. Here, then we are making the central portion of the letter H. Bring it towards the right side and then take it right to the top. One line, bring it slightly to the right and then back into the middle. Make the middle portion of the letter H top and then join the starting point to the end point. Last is the letter A. We have to make it slanted. Remember that. Remember the shape of the letter A like this. Then just click here so that the top of the letter A is made. Then the other side which is slanted again. And these small lines. Then come back to the middle. Go towards the left. Down here. And join the starting point. Remember, you have to make a small polygon inside the A also so that when we are coloring, the color looks nice and the letter appears nice also. So we make this polygon. Now our letters are written. All we have to do is fill with color. So take your pointer to the fill with color option. Click there, left click, and then click on color 1, the color that you want to choose. And fill it in the letter C. You can change the color 1. Fill it in the letter O. Again, we can change the color by selecting the color 1 as the pink color. We are filling the pink color in the letter M. We continue like this. Change the color. Fill it in the next letter by clicking inside the polygon. Remember, if the polygon is broken anywhere, if there is any gap in the lines, this color will spread to your entire paint sheet. So, whenever you make a polygon, remember that there should be no gaps in the lines that you are making. So, this way, you will keep continuing, change the color, fill it in the letter. So, computer is now looking very colorful. Next, let's fill in the color in the letter S and similarly in the rest of the letter Shiksha in all the alphabets. So, we keep changing color 1 by clicking on the color palette and getting a different color. We are filling it in I. Next, we fill it in the letter K. We are choosing a different color for the second S. We have chosen brown we fill it in the letter S, we choose a different color for the letter H, which is grayish color, we fill it here, and then for the last letter A, we have chosen this color and fill it here. So this way you can use the polygon tool and the fill with color option to make this colorful drawing of computer Shiksha. Now all of you save your paint file in the documents folder and properly shut down the system. In today's class, all of you practiced using the polygon tool and using the same you made many pictures like that of a butterfly and also of the words computer Shiksha. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.